This morning, Mark's taking on his most ambitious project yet.
Ta-da!
Believe it or not, this vaguely car-shaped pile of yellow scrap used to be a Porsche.
I know what you're thinking, it's scrap, but it's not going to be scrap. You've got to look outside the box.
Where it once turned heads, now it's more likely to turn stomachs.
It's kind of a shame, really, because I quite like the colour. It's kind of like baby sick yellow, isn't it?
The Porsche 924 first hit the roads back in 1976. Pitched as an entry-level sports car, it became one of the company's most successful models, selling more than 25,000 in just its second year of production.
My girlfriend, she was kind of excited with the word Porsche, and that's where the excitement kind of ended. It's not the greatest.
Thankfully, Mark has no intention of getting this old banger back on the road. Instead, he'll be ransacking its parts to create his latest work of upcycled art.
You gotta make the best of a good thing. So it's still got its engine, still got the gearbox, which has some really cool aluminium castings on it, which I quite like to use. And then if we go around the back, so this is what you're paying for. You're paying for this, Porsche.
Mark paid £250 for his Porsche. The challenge now is to find inspiration within its worn-out shell. In Lincolnshire, upcycling artist and designer Mark Wilkinson has just had a light bulb moment.
Some people might like it, some people might not. You're always going to get the haters.
After salvaging an old Porsche 924, Mark's decided to transform its cylinder head into a fully functioning table lamp.
Been doing a bit of sketching, and I've come up with a little idea. So here we have the head, the rocker cover, and then we'll have some copper pipe running through the centre, which our light bulb holders will be fixed to. It'll be like an engine candelabra kind of thing. But hopefully the proportion of it, because it will be sort of wide and narrow and quite tall, it should look quite cool, I think.
First task, strip the engine to create a workable space, within which he'll insert the cabling and pipes needed to house the light bulbs.
So I've got to start by removing all the parts off it. So this is the exhaust manifold. We don't need that. I think this is the water pump. We don't need that. And then the valves and anything that's kind of not necessary to make it into a lamp.
At its peak, the Porsche 924 boasted a maximum engine output of 168 brake horsepower.
The Yorkshire fitting. I love that it's called a Yorkshire fitting. I don't know whether a man from Yorkshire created it.
With a few adjustments, it'll now provide a combined bulb output of 160 watts.
It's just like one of those little balancing games. It's time to get the blowtorch out. Man, a bit fire. Right, so we're just going to warm these up, and as I warm it, the solder will melt.
A gallery awaits delivery of the table lamp in just 2 weeks' time. Mark needs to put his pedal to the metal. For a scrap sports car sculpture, the race is on.
Still a lot of cleaning to do, still a lot of making to do, still a lot of doing to do. But yeah, we'll see how it goes. I've got every faith in it. It should be fine.
Converted from a former hotel, Caffeine and Machine was set up by Phil McGovern in 2018 as a go-to pub for petrol heads across the UK.
It's become a cafe, bar, restaurant, 8-bedroom B&B, set in 10 and a bit acres of land, kind of automotive hangout.
Caffeine and Machine is an ever-evolving gallery space and shrine to cars, bikes, chromes and alloys. A prestigious venue for Mark's creation.
A little bit nervous, but it should be all right. Just don't drop it, yeah?
Phil hopes that Mark's lamp will sit well with the pieces currently on display and up for sale.
Look, you can see just by looking at Mark, he's an interesting dude, isn't he? So yeah, his stuff's going to be cool. Why wouldn't it be? I'm looking forward to it.
It's a 200-mile round trip for Mark and his lamp. If it's not up to spec, he'll be taking it back to Lincolnshire and looking for a new buyer.
This was a crushed Porsche 924.
Okay.
Which was at a friend's garage just down the road from my parents. And I messaged him and he's like, yeah, still got it, but it's flat now. So it's like, that's cool, I can still do something with that. And
how much fabrication's gone into it beyond the actual case that you've got?
Quite a lot.
A lot?
Yeah.
Let's check it out. Let's check it out. Show me. Are you going to do a very sensual, slow reveal? Or do you want to do the quick reveal? Come on then, let's have it. Reveal.
Ready?
Yeah, see, that's just wild, isn't it? That's wild.
From a broken and battered old sports car, a defunct engine has been reborn as a shiny new table lamp, ready for display in Phil's gallery.
Yeah, it's exceptionally cool, Mark.
Thank you.
Exceptionally cool.
Just
need that to be the switch.
No, the switch is on the end.
Even cooler.
Cool.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
How splendid. You.
Mark's hoping his lamp will fetch around £1,800. If Phil's response is anything to go by, finding a buyer should be a cinch.
That's not a cheap piece of work. There's effort and time. Quality and time is where the value is. It's a really cool piece of kit. And I hope someone walks in and just says they have to have it, because that's exactly why it needs to be here.
It's exactly the reaction Mark was hoping for. But saying goodbye to his latest creation comes with mixed emotions.
It's always a struggle to leave things behind. You spend all that time with it and working with it, and then you've kind of got to detach yourself from it at the end of it and let it go. And it is quite difficult, but you have to, otherwise you'll never sell anything and you'll end up with a house full of stuff.
After life in the fast lane, a rusty old sports car is set for the scrapyard. But from within its worn-out shell, a tiny part has a bright future.